Good morning, everyone. It's Saturday morning. Happy Saturday. Happy Passover to those that celebrate. And tomorrow is Easter Sunday. So I hope that you all had a good, good Friday. And we did. And now I am just finishing up my chores from this morning. It is 8:30. And so I'm just finishing up my chores already today. I do have to do the stainless steel, but we have a lot of cooking to do. Tomorrow for Easter, I'm actually going to my brother's house, and I'm looking forward to it. I haven't seen my brother in 3 months because he lives the privileged life, and he gets to spend the winter in Florida at his new house there. So he's back now, and we are going to be going to his house at some point tomorrow. I don't know when that is, but my brother lives literally 10 minutes from me, so it's okay. But we are bringing food with us. Frank is making his famous Frank's meatballs, and we are making eggplant, and I think that's all. And then I decided I want to make some desserts. My sister-in-law is actually making the desserts, so I don't have to. But I decided I want to just because it'll give Emilio and I a little activity to do. So we're going to make those cupcakes with the little bunny feet. Frank picked me up some frosting that we can make the tails with, and so we're gonna do that. And I would like to make the Rice Krispies treats with him because we didn't get a chance to do it last weekend because we were out most of the day on Sunday. So I have to get my nails done this morning because usually tomorrow would be my day, but it's Easter Sunday, so we're not gonna go. We're gonna have Easter bunny time tomorrow. And I have a few errands in town to pick up some things. And I don't know what else we're gonna do today. Maybe a trip to Barnes & Noble might be in the future for this evening. We'll see, but there's no definite plans. So whatever we do, we do. We spent a really nice night together last night. Frank went out to do the food shopping. It was pouring here, so it was silly to take everybody out. And Frank usually does the shopping, goes so much faster when just he goes, because when I go, I hold everything up. So it's just being honest. So he went and did the food shopping. I stayed with Emilio and the dogs, and Emilio and I watched Planes and Fire Rescue, I think that's what it's called. He picked it. I put out 6 movies for him, and he picked that one. He loves that one, and as soon as it was over, we watched it again. So when Frank came home, he loves that movie too. It's got a lot of country music in it, which we like, and it has music from AC/DC, and Frank's a huge AC/DC fan, so he really likes that movie. And so he watched it with us like midway through the first one and then some part of the second one before Emilio went to bed. On Fridays we let him stay up late. It's like his little treat. And he did so good this week. He went poop on the potty 2 times. I know, TMI, but when you're a mom, these things are important to you. So he did that, and I was like super proud. He has the idea of going on the potty. He knows how to do it. He just doesn't tell before he has to go. So someone gave me the tip that I need to just put him in big boy underwear and like a t-shirt and let him run around, and obviously he's gonna wet himself, but he'll learn that way. And we have to go to the potty like every half an hour. So I wasn't able to do that because it's been too cold, so we're gonna do that. The weather is getting nicer. Of course today it's 38, so it's still a little cold, but as soon as it warms up, I think we're just gonna be able to bang this out in a week, and he'll be good. He has the idea and knows what to do. So yeah, anyway, life of a mom. So where was I going with that conversation? Oh yeah, so we let him stay up late on Friday nights as his little treat. So he stayed up till almost 10 o'clock last night, and then he just like passed out cold. But he still takes naps. He still takes a 2 to 3 hour nap almost every day. So you know, he's not going all day long with no rest. He is getting that deep nap time. So yeah. So anyways, that's all the plans for this weekend. You know, there are really no plans other than tomorrow. And it's time to clip these suckers because they're long. And I lost one on the other hand, which happens to be the flipping the bird finger, so I'm not going to show it to you because that would just be rude. But I have to get that fixed, and I think I'm going to cut them. And I'll show you guys. I picked up 2 books from the library. to try them out, because I started reading one at the library, at Barnes & Noble last week, and I liked it, but the Nook book was $20, and I was like, I'm paying $20 for a Nook book. That's like as much as the book or more with my discount. So I said, let me take it from the library and see what I think about it, and if I like it, then I'll buy it. So that's typically what I do with my library books. I give them a try, and if I like it, then I'll buy it. On books that I'm not sure about, or something that's like I don't really want to read, you know, like, not that I don't want to read it, but something that I'm done, like, I have to have this. If it's like questionable, I'll take it from the library. So I want to show you some things that I got this week, and what I'm working on, my works in progress. What I'm still reading, the Elizas. I'm now 80% through with it, and now I'm enjoying it again, but during the week this week, I felt like I was slogging my way through it. It was so, like, slow in the middle, and I was so disappointed because it's a review book, and I was really enjoying it in the beginning, and then it got so slow, and I was like, no, I don't want to read it, but I kept going, and now it's good again. So now I'm going at a fevered pace to finish it so I can find out what happened here. It's getting real good. So there's that, and so I'm going to show you what I got this week, and I guess you'll just follow along with us for the day, and we'll see how it goes. You'll see our cookings and whatever we do, but yeah, we spent a nice night last night. We watched the movie together, we played games. I'm trying to think what we played last night. I can't remember, but we played games, and then Frank stayed down with me. The last few nights he stayed down with me instead of going to work, which is really nice to have him, because he's inundated with so much work, which is a blessing because obviously it brings money into the house. But there is so much work in his office that, you know, at night he needs to work to just be able to do it. And he works a full day every day. So he's out in the field a lot doing like measuring and meeting clients and looking at job sites and stuff. So he's away from the office a lot, and that takes away from his drawing time. So at nighttime he's able to get in his drawing time and just be quiet. He doesn't have to answer any phones or emails or anything like that. So I think it's more of a peaceful environment for him, and he gets more done that way. But then, you know, I miss him. So the last few nights he hasn't worked. He's just stayed down with us, and it's been so nice to have him there. Even if he falls asleep, it's nice to just have another body in the room besides the doggies. And he wakes up every once in a while and talks to me, so that's fun. We are just, I don't know what to say about Frank and I. We're just like, we were born for each other. We just match, and we find the same stupid things funny, and we'll watch stupid things over and over again and keep laughing. And that's when you know you find someone special, when you can laugh at dumb crap. So that's us. Anyway, so we had a really good night. I talked to a couple of you guys last night, and just random like messages that I got from people that I haven't spoken to in a long time. So it was nice to just chat for a little bit last night. I guess everyone's kind of in the spring feeling and kind of, you know, feeling revitalized and excited about the upcoming spring season, because we don't have it yet. We're supposed to get snow on Monday, so. But yeah, I think people are excited about the spring season and just feeling good and refreshed and, you know, just talkative. I think a lot of us went through the winter slump this year. I know a lot of people stopped coloring and started reading, or, you know, slowed down on their coloring, and I see a lot of it picking back up just based on my group. And then a few of the other groups that I belong to, I've seen a pickup in coloring and chatting, and so that's nice. I know I feel it myself, so I'm thinking some of you guys are feeling it too. So let me stop chatting your ear off here, and let me show you what I got and what I'm working on. Okay, so these are the two books that I get in from the library, In Every Moment We Are Still Alive and The House Between Tides. This is the one that was very expensive on the Nook that I just decided I would take from the library and see what I think. Also because it is like crazy small. This is not my library. They ship this into my library. Anyways, this is by Tom Malcolmquist. That's what it looks like to me. And this is the story of a man who, his wife, I believe, is sick, and she dies in childbirth, and he has to try to move on with his life and the new child, and I believe he meets another person, but that person's not who they turn, who he thinks they are. I think that's what it's about. I'm not really sure. I read it last week, like the synopsis, and that's what it sounded like to me. So I read the first few pages at Barnes & Noble, and I liked it, so I said, let me get that from the library. So I ordered that in, and then this one is The House Between Tides by Sarah Maine. Now, I saw this on a few channels, actually, this week. Who did I see it on? I saw it on Gwen W's channel. Oh, dang it. I don't remember who the other person was that showed this. Pooh. Well, whoever you were that showed this, you both convinced me that I should give this a try. So I'm going to give it a try. And it's the story of a woman who inherits a house and in Scotland, I believe. Oh, I think it was Sue's Book Nook. I think she was the one that showed it. I think so. So it was the story of a woman who... Yes, okay. It's the story of a woman who inherits a house, and the groundskeeper is going through the house to try to get it ready for her, and they find a skeleton, and there's like all kinds of... Hold on a second. Yes? What do you want, buddy? A car?
No cookies.
Oh, yeah. So some of the things that I got this week. This is the second time filming this because the same thing happened to me that happened last week. And the camera didn't switch over. And I had to edit that footage of the color in chat. And it got all messed up. And it was quite a hassle to fix it. And it wasn't even that great when I did fix it. So I'm just going to refilm this small part. So anyway, I got this book. This is called This. I don't speak French, so I don't know what that actually says. I'm guessing it's something about scenes in color. This is from Hatchet Heroes. This is a French Disney coloring book. I received this book from Mona as a gift. She sent it to me as a surprise, and I was blown away because I wanted this book so much, and she just sent it to me. She had it sent from France, and Mona, thank you so much. You already know how I feel about it and how much I love it. But I abandoned what I was working on to start something on this when I received this on Thursday. So the pictures are split up between Disney movies and Pixar, and there are a lot of pictures in here. But this is what I was working on since I got it. I started this on Thursday night, and I've been working on it slowly since then. I'm trying to color the people like they should be and doing the best that I can to match them up to the pictures, and I'm having so much fun with this. I absolutely love this book. It's a lot of light layers. The paper, it's not bad paper, but it's not terribly thick. It's thicker than like Create Space paper, but still I find that you get a lot of white space on it, so definitely have to do some light layers. But I'm so much enjoying working on this. Okay, sorry about that. So yeah, so I'm working on this, and I'll show you some of the other pages so you can get an idea of what's in here. Unfortunately, I can't tell you where to get it because, like I said, Mona sent it to me as a gift. I'm not sure where she got it from. I think they have it on, is it Amazon France? I think that's what it is, but I'm not sure that she got it there. I honestly don't know where she got it, so. You could ask Mona, though. She is our awesome mod. Look at this. Isn't this cute? I am going to have so much fun working on this book. That's all the really popular movies are in here. So there's a lot to color, and like the pages are huge. So you're not going to run through this fast. Yeah. Isn't that cute? I love it. I love it. I love it so much. Boo! I love Boo. She's so cute. Kitty. Anyways, so yeah, there's this, and I'm loving it, and I'm having so much fun coloring in it, and Mona, thank you so much for this wonderful, wonderful surprise. You guys are just so amazing and wonderful, and I so appreciate all of you. I got some adorable pug cards and a pug mug in my P.O. box recently. I put the pictures up on the Facebook page. I'll insert it here so you can see what I'm talking about. And I thank you so much for thinking of me. You guys know what I like, and you always are thinking of me, and I appreciate it. So That's the first book. The next book I got is, I got this not last week, but the week before, and I don't think I showed it to you guys. This is the new Color It book, Colorful Seasons. I really like their coloring books, so as soon as I saw this was out, I wanted to get it. I got the Christmas one, too, when that one came out. So I did work on one in here. I did this one. I had to take this out because Belle actually stepped on it and got a stain on the top, so I had to cut off the top and just take it out of the book. So I might actually tape it onto this page so that I can keep it in here because I like to keep my pages in my book. I do have a folder for loose things, but I kind of like to keep them in there. I use my Prismacolors on this, and they work really nice on this paper. So that is what I worked on here. I'll show you some of the pages here. Now, while I do that, I wanted to talk briefly about a post that I saw from Color It. They actually posted it on their Facebook page to let everyone know that I believe as of tomorrow, April 1st, the prices on their coloring books are going to be going up $2. So they're going to go from $17.99 to $19.99. And people on that post, I haven't been back to look at it, but when they first posted it, people were pissed off. Let's just put it like that. They were talking about that Color It's going to go out of business and how dare they raise the prices, and Color It said it's because of printing and paper costs rising that they have to do this, but people were not accepting of it and didn't feel that their pages, like their paper or that their pictures are worth it, and they were not going to pay for these books. This looks like, it always just reminds me of Hogwarts every time I see it, even though it has a weird moose there. It always reminds me of Hogwarts. I guess it's the owls and the way the buildings look. Anywho, so getting back to the discussion, yeah, so people are very upset and saying that they're, you know, they're not going to buy the books anymore and they don't feel that they're worth it. So cute. Look at that. Is that so cute or what? I don't want to turn the camera because then I mess it up. Let me turn the book. So, you know, it just brings me back to the conversation that I did last week during my coloring chat about the CreateSpace paper. You know, if they change the paper, like some people suggested, and you know what, thank you guys for all your comments on that. Some people said that, you know, they do like CreateSpace paper, some people said they don't like CreateSpace paper, but everyone was really nice about it, and I really appreciate that because, you know, we all have different opinions, and it's totally okay to share your opinion and talk about it, and I think we had good discussions about it. And the thing is, like I was saying, is that if the artists decide to go with different paper or a different printing press, most likely the cost of the books is going to rise. And with that in mind, you can see even a $2 increase really annoyed people. Now, do I think that these books are worth $20? I do, because you're getting a big binding, you know, you're getting a ring binding, you're getting really nice paper that you can use markers on if you put something underneath it, and you can use pencils, you can use watercolors, you can use whatever you want. But that's my opinion. I am not alone in that opinion, but then there are some people that don't agree with that. They don't think it's worth it. They think the pictures are amateurish. They think the paper is not worth it. They don't think the book is worth $17.99 even. I mean, now that it's going up to $19.99, they're not paying it. That's what they said. I'm just telling you what they said in the post. And that's going to be the same thing with the CreateSpace if they go to a different paper. The price is going to rise. That's just without a doubt. It's going to happen. And with that in mind, there are going to be people that are really pissed off that that has happened, and they're going to say the same thing, that they don't want to pay the price of the rising, you know, paper costs and all that kind of thing. Now, for me, I'm fortunate. I can afford that kind of thing, but not everybody can. So there is definitely going to be people that feel differently and say different things. And you know, that's just the way that it is. We're all different. And we all say things differently and see things differently. And also, you know, what costs is more worth it in some ways than others. So, you know, I would love to know your thoughts on that. How will you feel if the artists change their CreateSpace paper and move to different printing and charge more for the books? Would you be willing to pay? I mean, the CreateSpace paper books, some of them are like $8, $9, right? So if they went to $10, $12, would you be willing to pay that for those books? Leave it in the comments. Let me know. So the next thing that I got is, this is a Create Space paper book. This is Lacey Sunshine's Hippity Hoppity coloring book. This is brand new. I only got it, was it Monday? So I haven't had really any time with it because I was working on something else. I don't even remember what I was working on, but I was working on something else. And I haven't colored really anything in this yet. I did start it, but yeah, I started this one. And then Mona's book showed up, and I stopped. So I'm going to work on this tonight. I'm not going to work on Alice tonight unless I finish this. I'm going to work on this tonight because, damn it, I want to color one page in my Easter book here. So I think it's really super cute. And like I told you, I don't have any problems with the Create Space paper. So I like it. I like the images. I think they're just so cute. I'm not sure if Heather Valentin actually sells her images on Etsy, or I'm not sure about that. I'd have to look that up, but she might. And then you could have the different paper if you are absolutely adverse to Create Space paper, which I know some people are, and some people also don't like it because, you know, it hurts their hands, and I totally get that, you know?
Mommy.
Yes. Okay, sorry. My apologies for the interruption. I have to make a waffle for the boy. So the next thing I got is Phantomorphia by Kirby Rosanes. This is his new book, and I'm sure you guys have heard all the drama going on with this book. These are single-sided images. There's only 19 or something like that in here. People are also very mad about this. I've even seen posts in our group that they are returning their books. They are canceling their pre-orders. They do not like it. They do not want it. They're very mad at half the size, same cost, which I get, but you know what? That was an editor's choice, and the long and short of it is that he created enough for it to be the same size as all the other books, and the editor was like, nope, we're going to split this into two books to try to get as much money from this stuff as we can. So people were reaming him out, and I feel sorry about that, but the truth is that's what happens when you have an editor. So there will be one more book coming out in October, and I will be buying it, and the honest truth is that if you buy that book and you combine it with this one, then you have the full-size book. So, you know, that's the way I'm looking at it anyway. I like the book. I've seen Dee Dee do some really awesome work in it. So I'm looking forward to doing that too and maybe trying out some of her ideas to see how it works for me. Of course, you know, she's her and I'm me, so hers is going to be completely different and better than mine. But I don't care. I want to try it and use her ideas and stuff, so it's going to be fun to do, and she did some really creative stuff with it. I was actually watching her chat all about it that day, so it's going to be a lot of fun. So yeah, I'm going to work in it, and I'm going to like it, and I'm going to get the next book. And he said that now, due to all of this, it's going to be his last coloring book, but he said that before, so you never know. He could change his mind, but I like his work, so I'm happy to have that. And then, this was a total enabled purchase from Dee Dee. So Dee Dee, you may have enabled me I may have enabled you on the Hidden Paradise book, but you enabled me right back when you colored in this one. So, I had no interest in getting this at all, but then, you know, Dee Dee had to go and color in it. Thanks, Dee Dee, and then I had to buy it. So, it's a beautiful book. I don't know what they are doing. This is the one Dee Dee did. I don't know what they are doing with these books. They're going in and out of stock on Amazon, and I had decided I wanted to get it, and I went and it said temporarily out of stock, and I was like, well, that figures, because now I've finally decided to get it after I've hemmed and hawed over it for 2 weeks. Well, later in the day, it said they had 17 left, so I went ahead and ordered it. I don't know if they're going to pull these or they're going to reprint them or what, but it was all of their books, with the exception of the Halloween book, even the Nick Filbert book. So I don't know what Phoenix Amulet is doing personally with these books, but if you want one, probably get one of the books, because I have a feeling they're going to be going away. I don't know. Like I said, I don't know. These books are also very expensive. I mean, when these are full price, they're asking $21.99 for them. So costs of coloring books and nice paper is definitely going up. So I think that's something that we're going to have to face, especially if the artists start moving away from with Create Space and moving into better paper. So that's the story for now. I think I am going to work on my bunny so that I can get this done. I mean, I do have all day, and I'll probably have some part of tomorrow to color either at night or in the day. I'm not sure yet, but I want to do my bunny and get at least one Easter picture done. And I've done all my cleaning already this morning. The only thing I need to do is my stainless steel, and I can't do that because we're going to be cooking, and it's pointless. I'm going to have to do it 3 or 4 times if I do it, so I might as well just wait and do it one time. So waffles about done. Got to go make that for the kid, and I'm going to maybe have another cup of tea and start working on this, and I will catch up with you guys later. So I was talking about my breakfast last week, so I thought I'd show you guys what I have. So this is the yogurt that I like, the Stonyfield Organic Fat Free. I don't know why I like this one, but this one just tastes the best to me. This I think I showed you. So this is my mucilage that I put in there, and Frank got me blueberries last night, so I'm going to assemble it and then I'll show you. And I'm doing this because I love seeing what other people eat, so I'm hoping you will too. Okay, here it is. So there's my breakfast, and I am going to read my book while I have my breakfast. Yep. And then I'll get to coloring. Check-in time. It is almost 5:20, and I am working on this. I told you guys before I was going to do this. So, yeah, she's coming along good. I'm working on her with my Holbeins, of course, and I like it a lot. It's coming out very well. Emilio had a nap, so that's nice. Oh, I got my nails did. So here we go. It's like a hot pink and glitter, of course. And we made cupcakes. It was Emilio's first foray into making boxed cupcakes. So we made those, and we're gonna put the icing on them when they're cool, and we have this little cookie icing to make the little tails. So we have these little feet, and we're gonna put the little tail on it like that. So they're not quite cool yet, and yeah, so that's what we are going to do, and then we are going to go out to the diner because my son loves the diner, and then we're going to come back and we are going to make, we're going to dye eggs because he is so looking forward to doing this. So the last time we did this obviously was last year, but he was a little too little and don't think he's going to remember it. So it's going to be fun, and I will check back with you guys. Okay, the cupcakes are done. So the cookie, I didn't realize cookie frosting was going to be so watery. So as you can see, the tails didn't really work out. So I stopped doing them. I only did them on the two. And we got these cute little guys. And what I didn't have left, I put Reaster eggs on the other ones. So they came out cute. And Frank's over here. What are you doing? Icing your eggs?
Yes.
We boiled the eggs.
Stopping them from cooking so they don't turn green.
So we don't have green eggs and ham. So we've got that done, and those are going to cool while we're out. And, hello, Frank. So those are going to cool while we're out, and then we are going to dye eggs. I'm like brain dead today. Dye eggs, yes. So that's what we're going to do. So there's that. And now I have to go dress my child again because I had to take his clothes off because we were making these and I knew this was going to be a disaster. So going to do that. Dogs are fed. And then I got to like clean up the island a little bit. And then we're off and go get some dinner. Hi. So I just wanted to do a really quick check-in because I have to pack up stuff. It's almost 1 o'clock and we have to go over to my brother's house. So I'm ready to go. Frank's just getting out of the shower. He's almost ready to go. And we have all the food cooked and everything's good. I didn't get to film bunny time this morning because I have a weird hair going on here. Because Emilio came downstairs and he was like opening the stuff without a doubt. Like it was instantaneous, so there was no time to pick up the camera and film. But needless to say, he had a really good time. He had really good bunny time, and we enjoyed ourselves. My mom came over for some coffee, and now I am speeding out of here, but I will check back with you guys in a little bit. Okay, last check-in of the night. Emilio's asleep. He didn't take a nap today because we had a lot of fun at my brother's house, so he was super tired. And by the time we were done with prayers, he was already asleep. So Frank's taking a little nap with him since I had a little nap when we came home. So we had a really nice day. We had really good eats, that's for sure. And what did we have? We had Frank made meatballs and eggplant, and my sister-in-law made penne alla vodka, and we had roasted broccoli, and we had chickpea salad, and I feel like there was something else. I know there was sausages, and then desserts were amazing. My sister-in-law made rainbow, like, you know those rainbow cookies? Well, she made rainbow cake, rainbow crumb cake. It was to die for. I only had one piece because, you know, I'm trying to limit my sugars, but I could have eaten a lot more of it. So we had that. She made a bunny cake. We brought some of Emilio's cupcakes. She made an apple pumpkin pie. And there was something else. Was that it? I think that might have been it. But we had a really nice day. And we had fun outside. And I'm just, if you couldn't tell by the look of me, exhausted. So I'm going to color for a little bit. I'm going to flip you around, show you what I'm working on. I'm listening to my audiobook of American Ghost. I still am going through that. I'm still enjoying it. I finished my book this morning, The Elizas. I gave it 3 stars. It was good, but there was a lot of repeated information over and over again that, I mean, you're going to see my review because I'm on the blog tour for it, so I'll be talking about it. So I think I might start Sometimes I Lie. That was a review book I got, but I didn't get it till a few days before the book actually came out, so I wasn't worried about finishing it, but I think it came out last Tuesday, so I kind of want to read it. I'm really interested in it, and although I have other review books that are coming out soon, I want to read that one, so I think I'm going to dive into that one. I also want to read The Six of Crows. I've heard from Louise, the big-haired bookworm, that she really liked it, so I'd like to try that too. So we'll see. I'm going to make myself a cup of tea in a little bit and maybe start reading, but this is going to be my last check-in because I'm just going to show you what I'm coloring, and then I'm going to end the vlog for this week, so let me flip you around. Okay, so this is what I'm working on. I don't remember if I showed you. I was so tired last night, but I picked this picture from Color It. So I'm working on this one, and I'm working on the basket right now. I'm using my Prismacolors. I have my Nook right here with dog hair on it, and I'm listening to American Ghost. So I'm gonna continue listening to that. That's the book about the woman's great-great-grandmother that was a ghost in a hotel, and she does research on the woman and the ghost and all that kind of stuff, so I'm enjoying that. My boy's sleeping, and my girl, always right next to me. Belle is always with me. She even goes for car rides with me. When we went to go get grandma today, she came. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the vlog for this week. I'm sorry it wasn't as long as last week's, but we were kind of doing a lot of running around today, and my family really isn't into being filmed, so I didn't want to subject them to that. So we will see what we do this week. I don't know if I'll vlog during the week or just the weekend or whatever, but you will be along for it, and we'll see how it goes. And I thank you for joining. I hope you guys had a wonderful holiday, and I'll see you in my next video.